If you live or work in the San Francisco Bay Area region, you are likely aware that the area is prone to earthquakes and also possibly tsunamis, both of which, from time to time, can be devastating. But there are other more common emergencies and disruptions that affect our communities and day-to-day business as usual. The danger of wildfire is ever increasing as drought or near-drought conditions continue in California. Storms have the potential to flood low-lying areas and to cause landslides. There are momentary failures of our critical resources like power and water. And there are human-caused disruptions like public protests, celebrations of our local sports teams, or the damage and disruption caused by those who would promote chaos and terror. Each of these examples has one thing in common. That is the way that they potentially affect the community as a whole, and the way in which the community as a whole is needed to effectively respond. The idea of whole community response has blossomed as an underlying tenet behind effective community response since Hurricane Katrina in 2007. Whole community response means engaging all assets that the community has to offer to meet the myriad needs of the people in that community and to help them return to a sense of normalcy. This includes those assets and capabilities belonging to government agencies, as well as those belonging to community and faith-based organizations and local businesses. Just as businesses have a unique and important role in the economic and physical health of the community to which they belong, they also have an important role in community disaster response and recovery. Aside from traditional volunteering opportunities with organizations such as the Red Cross, Salvation Army, or local food banks, businesses can and are encouraged to engage with local government offices of emergency services or departments of emergency management. Knowledgeable and trained private sector partners can participate in local emergency management through private sector advisory committees and as part of a business operations center, or BOC, within an emergency operations center, or EOC. Through 2013 and 2014, the Bay Area Urban Areas Security Initiative, UASI, and the California Resiliency Alliance partnered with Bay Area Offices of Emergency Services to develop private sector advisory committees, PSACs, designed to establish robust and sustainable relationships before they are needed. Three printed guides were created to assist local government emergency managers in cross-sector partnerships. Those guides include a strategic plan to help establish and direct the work of a private sector advisory committee, a business operations center activation guide for private sector BOC representatives, and a business operations center activation guide for public sector EOC staff. These three guides detail processes and advice for establishing long-term and/or ad hoc BOCs in local government emergency operations centers, EOCs, as well as the ongoing operations of a PSAC. Each guide has an accompanying introduction video. This video is a companion to the Guide for Private Sector Partners, Business Operations Center Activation Guide for Private Sector EOC Representatives. It is designed to assist private sector partners to prepare and report to a Government Emergency Operations Center, or EOC, and establish a Business Operations Center, or BOC. The guide identifies processes and provides tools to activate and sustain operational public-private sector partnerships. A Business Operations Center helps emergency operations personnel communicate with the private sector to coordinate resources from businesses and facilitate economic recovery. A BOC is scalable. It can be a single business or industry representative in your EOC, or it can be a conference room with multiple representatives, such as the BOC at California's State Operations Center. A BOC can also be virtual or remote and physically separate from the EOC that it supports. The BOC is flexible. integrating into the EOC through different sections of the incident command system, depending upon the type of emergency and need for private sector support. This may include supporting one or more of the following. EOC command staff, where the BOC acts as a liaison to the pertinent business or industry and reports to the liaison officer. Operations section, which coordinates important response and infrastructure agencies, like utility companies. The BOC may also work in the operations section as part of a community branch. Logistics section, to assist in identifying providers or donors of resources. And finally, the Public Information Officer, or PIO, or Joint Information Center, JIC, to facilitate communication with the private sector. There are several ways that collaboration with the private sector through a business operations center can benefit disaster response and recovery. Businesses can provide real-time situational awareness about their business, employees, and immediate surroundings that can inform decision-making. Local businesses may be able to provide much-needed resources as donations, or may have skilled volunteers or capabilities that may be useful during recovery. By leveraging a wider reach and pre-existing relationships with the business sector in your community, the overall effectiveness of your emergency response, recovery, and infrastructure protection efforts are increased. Section 4 of the BOC Activation Guide for Private Sector EOC Representatives outlines the roles and responsibilities of those involved in the operation of a business operations center within the EOC. The Office of Emergency Services may appoint a BOC liaison to work with the BOC private sector representatives in the EOC. A BOC team leader may be appointed, who will be the primary point of contact for the BOC private sector representative team, particularly to determine activation and shift assignments. Strategic roles for the Private Sector Advisory Committee, PSAC, include advising local government on available resources. Operational responsibilities for BOC private sector representatives during EOC activations include facilitating communication and coordination with the private sector. The role of a private sector BOC representative requires preparation and offers an opportunity for training. The Private Sector Guide provides tips for preparing to report to the EOC, the things you should bring with you, and the training that you will need to complete to be most effective. Almost all of the training can be taken online through the FEMA training website and includes ICS, EOC operations, and primers on public-private partnerships. Further information about activating as private sector representatives in the BOC is provided. The BOC is usually activated by the EOC director, who also makes the request for private sector representatives through the BOC liaison and the BOC team leaders. Throughout the guide, the need for representatives to act in an ethical fashion, keeping sensitive and possibly competitive information confidential, is stressed. The next section of this guide provides a toolkit for use in preparing for and during BOC activation. The toolkit includes a position description outlining the responsibilities of the private sector representative, which include facilitating communication and informing the EOC of the status of private sector partners and any resources that they may be able to offer to assist. As with all EOC operations, the BOC team should be prepared to provide information to EOC management and the incoming team during personnel shift changes. It is important that the efforts of the private sector representatives integrate smoothly with EOC operations. The role summary in the toolkit provides information to do that. The private sector representative should check in with the appropriate EOC personnel upon arrival, send approved information to private sector partners at the start of each shift, and become familiar with fellow community agency representatives in the EOC. The private sector representative should help coordinate available private sector resources and communications with private sector partners. This may require establishing and conducting conference calls throughout the activation. To further assist smooth BOC operations, the toolkit also includes a private sector representative position checklist for initial activation, sustained BOC operations, and demobilization of the EOC and BOC. Examples of key functions the BOC can perform and the ways that private sector BOC representatives can support EOC operations are provided in this toolkit. They include information sharing, the development and distribution of situation reports to the local business community, and acting as a conduit for guidance, situational awareness, and information requests with special emphasis on the restoration of critical lifeline systems and supply chains. Distribution lists and communications protocols. In coordination with the Private Sector Advisory Committee or key employers in the area, developing alert and notification protocols and systems. Confidentiality and the appropriate handling of information by private sector BOC representatives is stressed throughout the guide and toolkit. Logistics and resource coordination. The BOC can assist with requests for and deployment of private sector resources as donations and/or volunteers. Established CalOES BOC partners include national retailers and industry associations that work together to make resources available. The toolkit also provides information about the CalOES Good Samaritan Liability Protection Registry, which provides protection for private sector partners. A list of partners that may be able to assist with the most commonly needed resources for use by the BOC representatives should be developed and regularly updated. A sample from the CalOES is provided in the toolkit. Additional tools that you can use to develop and operate a business operations center in your local EOC are provided in the appendices of the guide. These include ICS forms and acronyms that are commonly used in BOC operations in the EOC. Business Operations Center Activation Guide for Private Sector EOC Representatives will help private sector BOC representatives effectively operate a BOC as part of a government EOC during emergency response and recovery. The tools provided are designed to assist in both BOC development and operations. The remaining two videos will help government EOC personnel to develop and sustain cross-sector partnerships, both strategic and operational, to benefit community emergency response and recovery, the first describing the value of ongoing engagement through a private sector advisory committee, and the last providing tools for the development and operations of a BOC. With the three written guides and accompanying videos, you are now armed with the tools to establish robust and resilient partnerships. Partnerships that will facilitate a whole community response and more effective recovery from disruptive events that may affect your community.